A great storm has spread across the world of Domen, shattering the landscape and unleashing skeletal foes called Rawbones. The tribes of Domen retreated into the cities of light, protected by the magical Lumo shields. Over time, the cities of light lost contact with one another, presumed destroyed in the shattering. Now, a coordinated team of city guildmasters work together to evacuate the last survivors to the final remaining city of light.
To move fast! The Lumo shield is collapsing and Rawbones are swarming the city!
What's the haps? I'm Meroka and welcome back to SkySaga. It has been a while, has it not? It has been a couple of alphas. I didn't play it at all during Alpha 9 and I don't think I played it much to any great extent during Alpha 8 either, really, all things considered. So I know a lot's changed. That has changed. That is new. So I'm feeling the itch. I'm feeling the SkySaga itch, and I kind of want to get it back into it with Alpha 10 because it is looking different, fleshed out. It has a story, guys. Okay, let's head on in.
We have to evacuate to the docks. Follow me.
I'm right behind you.
Come on.
I know that we just start the game as kind of just anonymous warrior. I know it's tutorial and stuff, but do I kind of want to have a nosy? Because that's what I do, right? Although it's not letting me climb things as well as I want to. This invisible wall is stopping me. I think they thought about how much I like to climb on cities and try and break the game. They know there's me and there's a lot of people like me who are like, hey, let's see how much stuff we can find in this world.
The Lumo shield has fallen. The city is falling apart.
I'm trapped.
You have to find another way round. Find a sharp stone and smash your way through.
Alrighty. This is how we learn things. Instead of just the whole follow the things, we have reasons to do the things. How about that? So this has changed a little bit. Right-click on the inventory to equip it. Everything's in different places, I guess. We're going through this way. Whoop. That's just there for dramatic effect. Can I smash my way through that? I can't. No, it just vanishes because magic. Alrighty, that's fine.
Good. You made it. Let's become friends in case we get separated again.
Good to make friends on a battlefield. Yeah, sure. Okay, this is how we learn how to do social things, I suppose.
Now, I need your help. The other guildmasters are trapped, and I can't save them both. You'll have to help one, and I the other, okay?
Gotcha. You get to choose? Would these, like, give us points for different factions?
Mermish's escape route has been cut off. You'll have to bridge that gap if you want to save him.
Right.
Peregrine is surrounded by Rawbones. You'll need to fight them off if you want to help him escape.
Understood. Interesting. So yeah, wow. Right off the bat, we've got do you want to do the adventuring path or do you want to do the building path? We ain't gonna touch the whole PvP path this bit. First, we gotta pick one of these. I always did kind of have a soft spot for building a little bit, but I'm a big adventurer as well. Let's see what the building path looks like.
That's the spirit. You rescue Mermesh, and I'll save Peregrine. Take this pickaxe and build a bridge over the gap.
Got it.
We'll regroup at the airship dock. This isn't going to be easy. Are you ready to be a hero?
A bridge-building hero.
Ah!
That was not what I expected when I was told I was going to be doing bridge building. But okay. This is more of a PvP kind of bridge, I guess, then. It's just, let's just make blocks across to get to where we need to be. I'm not going to be an elegant, aesthetically pleasing... Pleasing? Pleasing. Pleasing or pleasing? Aesthetically pleasing bridge. Designed to look good. In a, some manner of beauty contest. Nope. This is going to be a, I need to get this guy out kind of bridge. So, let's do that. Interesting that, yeah, we've got your slots at the bottom there, 1 through 6, and then kind of the active slot is then indicated with 2 at the top as well. Do I have to fill all of this in specifically? I mean, I don't really, all things considered, need to make a double wide bridge. That seems like overkill for the purposes of extraction. I should probably hit control and move just to tell the tutorial that I actually do know what I'm doing, because that thing ain't going away otherwise, right? And the way the building works, you don't need to control. Press control to get to build over edges. That's... I wonder if that's just something that has confused a lot of Minecraft players, that they put that in there just so that it's like, yeah, you guys have built things with cubes before. This is how you do it. Hey, like, yeah, don't need to hang over the edge. You just kind of do that. See? Hi there. I got you out.
Thank you, hero. Your building instincts are sharp. Were it not for you, this may have been my final stand.
Thanks, Bane. I'm just glad I got here in time.
Take this. It is a keystone imbued with the last of the city's Lumo energy. You can use it to boost your rewards.
Cool. Collect the thing. Right, what does that do? Keystones are rare and powerful Lumo relics, which can be used to enhance your rewards. Try it on the sword you just received to boost its power. That is not how I remember keystones working. What? Okay. Boost your rewards with keystones. So, the reward is a common forest stone, but if I have keystones, it's better. That... I will tentatively accept that, but with the caveat that that smells a lot like free-to-play, freemium kind of mechanics. It's like, oh, here's some stuff. It's kind of okay. But if you pay us a dollar, you can have more. That's... I've seen that far too often. So, is yeah, you can have just that, or you can use the one keystone that he just gave us. Oh yeah, look, get more down here. I guess we have to buy them. Is this not a thing we craft anymore? Do we not craft keystones? So we can just get more keystones, and we can use it to boost our rewards. All right, let's...
I apologize, but formal introductions will have to wait. The Lumo Shield has fallen, and our home lies in ruins.
Can't believe it.
We must abandon it. Regroup our strength and devise a plan.
But where do we go now?
One option remains. A final city of light still stands, untouched by the vile darkness of the shattering.
Really?
This is where we must go. To the city of last light.
To the city of last light. And that's where we're the big reveal. I kind of was expecting us to get to the city first light and then to say, reveal yourself, hero, let us see your face, and then that would be it. No, we just take our helmet off on the ship because the fighting's over. Alrighty, well, let's lean towards our usual characters, but I'll tentatively have a look and see what new options are. It seems like the four standard races that existed before continue to exist. We've got humans, we've got cats, we've got lizards, we've got monkeys. We were not totally pasty. We were... that. In this lighting, I kind of look a little bit grey, but I think it's just the dim lighting. We have... oh my god, we can... oh, we can have a background to our character. Ooh. Okay, we can be an Arden city dweller, an Arden sky sailor, an Arden villager, a gnarly ice fisher, gnarly ice strider, gnarly king's hearth. It's a king's hearth. You lived in an old gnarly underking settlement, keeping the city surrounding a deep hearth alive. You braved Harshnose, a gnarly ice strider who patrolled overground to uncover old underking ruins. I'm guessing these kind of have some bearing on what our starting island's going to be. It's going to be like, are you forest or are you ice? It's probably what that one boils down to. And there may be like a couple of options for each race or something. Gnarly Ice Fisher, you roamed free as a gnarly ice fisher, a group known for patience and determination in mastering a shifting, treacherous landscape. Kind of like the fisherman kind of thing. Gonna be honest. You worked hard as a farmer or hunter in the scattered settlements of Arden Forest. You sailed the skies as a member of the Fellowship of Arden's vast skyship fleet. Also cool. You're a citizen of one of Arden's great cathedral cities, the seat of power and trade throughout the entire Fellowship. Okay, it's either fisherman or sky sailor. Probably going to lean towards the Sky Sailor, but slightly concerned that that's just going to give me like a forest starting island, and they're kind of boring. Anyway, yeah, features. We have faces. We have several faces. Were there several faces before? We can have slightly angry face, or happy face, or face that we have seen before. Eye color is... I don't know, what color eye color do I normally give Meroka? Blue or green? Probably one of the two. Blue, possibly. And my signature color is definitely teal. I'll go the green. Teal goes with my eyes better. My hair was... let's see. I think most of these are fairly familiar. That's pretty cool, actually. I like that. That seems kind of new as well. Which one did I go? I mean, is the one I used to use there... that doesn't seem like... I think it was this one, but I think they've remodeled it somewhat. It wasn't that one. It was more of a spiky kind of affair, I think. Like that, but spikier. Or you can go bald. It's not a great look. Not big on bald. Dreaded bob. Oh, yeah, I kind of dig the dreads. What color dreads? Pink. It looks like that should be more of an orangey kind of color, but it comes out kind of blonde. I think the red kind of works. Red dreads. Yeah. And we have accessories. Earrings kind of only work with some haircuts, I guess. They stick slightly through my hair. Fair enough. Spiky earrings. Oh, you can kind of see them. Arden bloom earrings. Okay, so you can see the accessories. Just pearl drops. Possibly the spiky ones, because you can see them the most. Markings? Oh, do we get to go all tribal and stuff? Cool. We have a scar and a beauty spot. A teal beauty spot. A warrior stripe. A brow knot. War paint. Or saber stripes. Maybe that one? Is there more? There's this slider here, but that doesn't actually go up and down. Oh, we can change the color of them as well. It's not all the same color. Guess I go with the scar. None of these really look like... It's blue. A scar shouldn't be blue, you know, right? I have it slightly different color to my signature stuff. And oh my god, okay, yeah, now we can change all the other bits. Alright, oh no, this is just... These are all the color palettes we've already seen, but it just puts all the color palettes in one place. Okay, that's kind of interesting. I guess signature color changes quite a lot of it. Most of it's just controlled by that, really. Still gonna go with that. I guess we're okay with this? I think we're okay with this. Cool. What's this? We have found a map? My words. Hey, title screen, 15 minutes later. This is the Atlas. You can use it to travel to the many locations in SkySaga. Open the atlas within and select your destination. Ah, neat. Okay. So we can just fly to the adventures. We can visit the... I'm guessing maybe they've done away with the keystones in so far as it was just a slightly trivial and slightly arbitrary barrier to entry to starting levels. And it was like, why are they necessary? You know? And then, of course, there was always technically, not really practically, but technically the risk that you could run out of keystones and not be able to go on an adventure. Which I think last time I played the game, they had at least added a few random adventures that you could kind of go on for free. I guess they've kind of just made it so there's like random adventures that you can pick out, and the mission system, perhaps? These things in the corners that look like they might be places are not places. So we have adventures, City First Light. Ooh, some of the featured things that people build, I guess, will wind up there. PvP, and PvP, and PvP. There appear to be two different forms of building PvP. I'm not sure what the difference between a build-off and a build contest is, but I am intrigued to see those. Island browsers are, I just guess, other people's stuff. Blueprints are... These are all community stuff for the most part. That will presumably be mine when I get one. I guess we have one starting point, really.
Welcome to the City of Last Light. This city is a safe haven, a refuge for all who seek it.
Amazing.
I am glad to see you escape the shattering, friend. Fortune has smiled upon you.
Well, indeed.
We were lucky. Everyone who escaped was. Mermesh and Peregrine got out safely, as did many, thanks to the brave actions of Eva and the other heroes.
Well, it was certainly a close one.
Sadly, Eva herself did not make it.
Oh, I hope she's okay.
But we must try not to dwell on such sadness. I am Harana, the city treasurer. It is a pleasure to meet you.
And the same to you.
If you are ever in need of knots, I buy items at very reasonable prices.
Good to know.
Now, I am sure you are eager to explore. There is much to see. Seek out Mermesh in the Settlers Plaza, the building behind me. He will help you get started.
Got it.
May fortune favor you, my friend. And once again, welcome.
Thanks. Ah, right, we're in the new City of First Light, which looks similar to, but distinctly different from the one I remember. Fair enough. Cool. Alright, let's go for a wander. You are... Oh, this is where we do treasure, Amber. Yeah, you're not hidden, tucked away at the back anymore. You're pretty up front and center. Which, given that that's someone who you ended up talking to a fair bit, it's probably more useful than having to trek halfway across the city for it. Here we have guild services. Yeah, cool. Never did get involved with the whole guild kind of thing, but that's good to know it's there. N is flashing down there to tell me you should probably have a look at something. I don't know what I've unlocked, but photos, I guess. Maybe? Oh no, it's down there, it's flashing, but when you go in there it tells you nothing. So, who knows? These are cool. I guess all the doors are just automatic now. Fair enough. Mermesh is our man. The merman. I want to see other things before I actually talk to him, though. That is Nazak's crafting materials. Ashket's decorative items. Fair enough. All shopping in one little indoor bazaar kind of affair. It's kind of nice. Pella's supplies. What is that? What do you have? Do you have a mustache? He has a mustache. I ain't never seen a guy with a mustache in this game. We have discovered the technology of facial hair. Can I talk to you? Hi. I want to buy your things. Can I... Maybe I can't buy things until I've finished all the intro stuff, I guess. Here we got... Beasts. He has a chicken hat! And a chicken coat, I suppose. And chicken boots, as well, for that matter. I kind of want the chicken hat. I ain't gonna lie. Do kind of want the chicken hat. The rest of it, I'm less sold on, but the chicken hat's so stupid, I gotta have it. Vari the Red sells blueprints. Alrighty. We have... Kameka's Lumo Stones. Oh, right. I can talk to you. Hello. Oh, new arrival! I have many exciting things to show you, but you ought to stick with the Guildmasters for now. Come and see me later, though, I promise. Great! Excellent. Alright. Cool. That's the new technology that they added in Alpha 9. That I'm not sure what it is. It sounds like, if we're going to continue as we always do, making the inevitable and invariable and unchanging comparisons to Minecraft, because every game that is made of cubes must, it's most fundamentally compared to Minecraft, it's kind of redstone, I think. I think it's kind of redstone. The Settler Guildmaster, alright. Can I talk to you?
So you have arrived at last. I am overjoyed to see you are alive and well, hero.
This place is amazing.
We are blessed to have found such a majestic place to call home. And I am honored to welcome you to it.
I am so glad to be here.
I am Mermesh, leader of the Union of Settlers. Though the threat of destruction still looms below us, my guild works to bolster the city's defenses and hold back the darkness.
It's a valiant cause.
I would be honored if you would join us.
The honor is all mine. I accept.
By building, sharing islands, and completing challenges, we can generate energy to strengthen the Lumo Shield.
That's amazing.
I would like you to visit one of the featured islands and complete its challenge.
Well, that sounds good. Okay, visit the featured islands and complete its challenge. Now, I wonder, is this... Yeah, created by SkySaga. Okay, so the first one is literally something that the devs have implemented, but I presume that these will change either once we're beyond the tutorial or later into Alpha 10 to be player-driven stuff. But yeah, let's go do the starter stuff. Kind of seems like a bit of a tecton mechanic, though. It's the, oh, if you do races and things, you make the shield stronger. It's like, that makes no sense. Honestly, if the mechanic had been kind of, oh, you must build fortifications and cannons and things, you must repel the evil, it would be like, that's kind of cool. Like, you're making building sound actually really cool. But he didn't do that. He was like, you must go and play with your friends, and that defends us against evil. It's like, no, you could have made it cool. This is a promoted island. It features a challenge which you can complete to earn rewards. If you finish it fast enough, you'll claim your place on the leaderboard for all to see. You can win treasure ambers of currencies and keys, treasure ambers of resources and components, treasure stones, treasure ambers of Lumo stones and Icor, treasure stones for promotions. Or is that a promotion? Do I get a promotion? Or is it a promotional item? I don't know what that is. Cosmetic. Oh, does it tell me? No. Cosmetics and emotes. Fun. Lower chances we have getting some heroic stuff. That sounds like that's really good from like starting stuff. I guess it's green. That kind of tells me exactly kind of how good it is, I suppose. Settler gear D? Settler gear C? Oh, C is the, like, okay, I was thinking it was D quality? No, it's not. And then various furnitures and things. Fair enough. Let's go! Let's do a race. I guess this would be the race. Let's do it! Let's go! Oh, I thought that was it. I thought that was literally... I shouldn't have stopped. It kind of seemed like that was the end. Whoops. Yeah. The winner did it in 16 seconds. I did 19. Well, that was disappointing. I can boost my rewards with keystones. Should we click on this and find out what this does? Each keystone requires 5 keystone fragments to craft. 5 out of 5... chances to craft remaining. So I can just drag and drop that in there. Raft Max. Okay, so it's not a guaranteed. Is it a guaranteed keystone? Oh, it is. I note the word chance. 3 out of 5 daily chances to craft remaining. I did get them. They did go there. I expected there to be more, a little, just a touch more fanfare or something, but no. Just number goes up is basically what it is. So I have 2 of those, but I note specifically the terminology chance, which, so maybe it's the first 5 are guaranteed and beyond that, it's a bit hit and miss as to whether you get any or not, so you're limited daily. It hasn't asked me for money yet, which is what I was concerned about. But at the same time, it is still a free-to-play game, and they still, to date, after several years later, have not asked for a penny. So there's always that kind of lingering over the whole game as to, when are they doing that? When are they planning to ask for money? And from whom and for how much? That's always going on. But, okay, we got those. And I can boost my rewards to get 2 treasure... Okay, so I get 1 treasure amber, or I can use 2 keystones to turn it into 2 treasure ambers. As if the first time you completed this island while it's promoted, you get a prize. Okay, I guess you probably don't get, like, treasure ambers for every single time you do a quest or a race or something. So I probably should just boost that, right? This is just the, hey, here's a thing because you did the thing. Okay, well, I can go now. So I got those. I can go get those redeemed in the city. I know I can go home. Thanks, tutorial. I did kind of want to do that faster. Where we go? Oh, there's our leaderboards. We are probably not high up the leaderboards. Am I not? Does it not show you where you are? I don't see my name on there, and it would be, you know, it would be traditional to put one's name, put the player's name when they arrive at the leaderboard in front of them. Probably, where were we? I was about 19 seconds, wasn't I? So it should have been in that region. Oh, who really knows? We can always go for another run round. Go for another quick run round. See what rewards change. Do I have some? Oh, okay. I don't think I have sprint specifically. I think that may have held me up a bit, because I think I just kind of did a dash instead of a sprint. That's what I thought I was doing. Well, that was better than I achieved last time. I think we should just probably go now. City of Last Light. Oh yeah, there's a totally different featured island up top now. I wonder if they just put 3 there every day and it's just like, yeah, pick one of the 3. Or pick all of the 3, in fact, and get daily rewards for doing them all, maybe. Okay, City of Last Light. Can I turn my things in now? I hope I can. Are you here to learn about treasure ambers? You've come to the right place. I am Tao Ying, and I know more about these mystifying artifacts than anyone in all of Domoon. I see. The shattering causes only ruin. Some artifacts can resist destruction by encasing themselves in magical shells. These are known as treasure ambers. So you have managed to obtain some. How interesting. How did you know? I've devoted my life to the study of artifacts. Treasure amber is my specialty. Here, give them to me. I've mastered the art of purifying the amber. You may keep whatever item lies inside, but the shells are mine. They will have no value to you. Oh, I see. There's some sort of, again, wishy-washy explanation for why she offers this service. She wants the magical shells. Also, she totally didn't explain how she knows that I've got them. You looked in my pockets. Oh, that seems fair. If you find any more, bring them to me. I will purify them for you. You can even buy them from my surplus stock if you wish. I hope to see you again very soon. New arrival. I'll be keeping my eye on you. Sure you will. Alrighty. Make it happen. Purify it. It is. Da 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 da. Keystones. Okay. Well, that's cool because that's a currency of sorts, I guess. And. Da 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 da! This animation still looks kind of weirdly jank compared to everything else in the game. I don't know how or why. That is a mark of some sort. Okay. Neat. Neat, neat, neat. Okay. So, I'm gonna go now. And I have ranked up. That means presumably rewards are awaiting at this mailbox. Hero rank 1. Have they kind of done away with the idea of paths? Is it just one singular rank now? Because I note the marks previously were in different types of currency as well. That was just a mark. Yeah, it's like there are 50 generic marks. Not marks of adventuring and marks of building and stuff. Just marks. Okay, fine. Let us learn the things we learned. Can I... Oh, yeah. I have to equip recipes. Right. And... Oh, it didn't give me a pickaxe. I thought it gave me a pickaxe recipe there. It didn't. It just gave me literally another pickaxe. So now I have two pickaxes. Fine. And you made a you learned how to make a basic door in a specific color scheme. Do I have to learn a different door for every different color? You've learned the red door. You have learned the blue door. You have learned the green door. That sounds faffy.
Welcome back, hero. I hope you have been inspired. Though the shattering has decimated much of our world, we will continue to build with passion and determination. We will protect our home. That is the aim of the settlers.
It is a noble aim indeed.
I look forward to seeing what you will create. But before you can start, you will need somewhere to build. Speak to Morad, the well-traveled. He will be able to help.
Excellent.
You should also seek out Peregrine and get involved with the Alliance of Explorers. I know he will be thrilled to see you.
I'll do just that. Farewell! Okay, I guess Morad's the man. Murad, the man that's got our house waiting for us. And there's also Peregrine that we should probably see about. We should see Peregrine about the other quest, but I'm more interested in a house right now, I guess. So, is that up on this ship? It appears to be up on this ship. Murad, the well-traveled, hello. You have some silly goggles.
Ahoy, newcomer, Mara the well-traveled, they call me. Above all, Doman, I've sailed to the farthest corners of the sky in search of adventure. Now I held the ultimate game, Sky Islands. I'm guessing Mermesh sent you.
He certainly did.
You'll be wanting this then, a Sky Island from your own...
His first line didn't give me this impression. He's a pirate.
You'll be wanting this then, a Sky Island from your own fleet. Every new arrival needs one, Captain Mermesh's orders. At Waker, we can all build until the shield is nigh unbreakable. Head there now and make her your own. Place some blocks, dig up others till it feels like home.
I will.
Before you rush off, speak to Vari. She'll show you blueprints which will help you tame that island of yours. I'll be here if you need me, preparing me ship the Caspian for another hunt.
Got it. Vari, where would you be found then? Probably up here, I suppose, where the blueprint icon is. We merely have our generic XP bar up the top, I am noting. And I guess we can interact with all the guys now, because everyone's got different stuff. Yeah, let's have a nosy at Lumastone.
Hey, you've got a camera. Did you know that I come to the famed Lumomancer invented it? It's one of my many incredible Lumastone creations.
Awesome.
Yes, hey, how about you use that camera to take a photo of Kentigern the Rawbone for me? Don't worry, he may seem utterly terrifying, but he's harmless. Supposedly. You do this and I'll open my Lumo shop for you.
That's a deal. Where the hell is Kentigern?
Around here? I don't know.
Various who we're told to talk to.
Well met! So Murad sent you to learn about blueprints. Well, you came to the right place. They're my specialty. With them, buildings made simple. No need for sitting around boring yourself silly with endless planning.
I'm intrigued.
It'll be clear once you try it for yourself. Take this blueprint and place it on the aisle. And just throw in the stone blocks and bam, your very own castle entrance. No need for waiting around. When you're finished, I'll even open up my blueprint shop for you.
Can't wait to try it. Ooh, we can have a blueprint projector. Oh, do we get both those? Blocks and a blueprint projector. Yeah, cool. Neat. Right, so can we go to an island now? Our home island seemed like a good place to go. Cool. Forest ruins. Edit private. It's presumably what the button it's telling me to click on. Meroka's Forest Ruins, it seems like a good place to build a thing. Let's do that then. I've got one of these. Equip, I guess? Yeah, okay.
then that's... Oh my. Right, this is... Where do I place this? Ah, okay, it needs a lot of space. Okay, oh, I see. It's kind of projecting the blueprints already. I figured it was a thing that you put down and then... Yeah, I guess that's right. Really difficult to see when you're working with such big things up close, but yeah, that actually seems like that's exactly the right place to put that. How do I change it to other things? Oh, okay. Simple castle entrance by SkySaga. Drag and drop 210 white stone blocks here, and it will turn into a thing. Not sure how you would change to other things just yet. I note there's a thing down there that says 9 keystones? What the significance of that is, I don't know. Oh, I bet you can use keystones to speed up building, can't you? Use to complete this device, all collected resources will be built into the world! Yep, do it. Oh, that was pretty quick, pretty quick fast. Phone's going off. Do you know you can create your own blueprints? When one's sold, you'll take a cut of the profits. If you're interested, come see me. I'll give you a blueprint draft for free. Or if you just want to see what else is available, check out the blueprint browser on your atlas. Awesome. I'm gonna have to dabble with that, I feel. Let's go see what mail awaits me on my home island. Publishing your island! Now you have an island of your own, you may want to publish it. That way folk will be able to come and visit and marvel at your creations. Before you can publish, it'll need an activity. So I've enclosed this gift, a viewpoint. Place it on your favourite feature. Visitors will be charged to find and photograph it. Ah, cute. Take your time to get your island looking shipshape. When you're happy with the work, place the viewpoint and publish your island. Ah, alright, neat. I like that. That's pretty cool. Cool, now that we have a home of sorts, I guess we don't go through the whole cave thing. You can see where you used to have to go down to get into caves and stuff, and maybe the caves do still exist if you keep digging. But I guess the point of the home is now more just do it up, turn it into a home kind of thing, because the keystone portals kind of seem to have been done away with just sail between islands using your airship, because, you know, SkySaga, you have an airship, what's with the portals? Let's just fly everywhere, that's cool. But yeah, now that we have a home, it probably seems like a reasonable place. I've rambled quite long enough for a first episode, I think. We've got to grips with the basics, we've got a home. It's all good. It's all gravy. I'm going to delve a bit more into this, but not today. Thank you for joining me. I've been Meroka. This has been SkySaga. I'll see you next time. Yeah!